वेलकम टू आप आईएस। सो फ्रॉम टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू इनिशिएटिव विच इज नेम्ड डेली न्यूज़पेपर प्रक्स। सो अंडर दिस इनिशिएटिव वी विल समराइज यू द हिंदू, पीआईबी, लाइव मिंट, इंडियन एक्सप्रेस, टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया एंड लाइव मिंट, ऑल इंपॉर्टेंट सोर्सेज दैट आर रिलेवेंट फॉर योर एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, एंड वी विल कवर ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट विच इज इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जाम पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज डिस्कशन। So the first article appeared in the Hindu edition is recently the government has banned 59 apps of China, including the sensationary TikTok app. So guys, you might be using, but now you should not use this app as per the government guideline. So according to the Ministry of Information and Electronics, there were credible reports that these apps pose threat to the sovereignty and integrity of India. So the government disallowed the use of these apps. So the point to be noted here is the government has invoked Section 69A of Information and Technology Act, which was read with the provisions of information technology procedure and safeguard for blocking access, formulation of public rules 2009. So the government, in accordance to the credible inputs received, has banned these apps, and in a sequential manner these apps will be removed from Google Play Store as well as all the play stores or sites that are accessible in India. So the Ministry of Information and Technology also said that Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center has also received exhaustive recommendation, means the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center has given recommendation to MIETY that some of the apps may contain malicious softwares which may endanger the security, that is data of an individual. So you might have read about data protection law. So government is recently focusing more on sovereignty and the interest of an individual in all digital as well as natural forms. So let's see the next article appeared in the Hindu as well as other newspapers. So the next article appear here is about RBI. So recently the Reserve Bank of India has announced another purchase auction worth rupees 10,000 crore, which will be held in the month of July. So in this, the Reserve Bank has decided to sell the securities via OMO, that is open market operation. So this is done because that will give operational twist, that is it is aimed at managing the yields, and it will also help the yield on long tenure bonds that have stayed elevated and government has borrowed earlier. So the point to be noted here is only the open market operation that is relevant from your point exam point of view. So OMO is basically the buying or selling of the government securities in open market, hence the nomenclature is also called open market operation. So this is done in order to, that is a kind of monetary policy tool of RBI, means the policy tool which enables RBI to control the liquidity flow in the market. So there are two types of open market operation, that is outright purchase, PEMO. This is permanent and involves outright selling of, buying and selling of government securities. And whereas second is repurchase agreement, that is repo, that is you might have heard the repo rate, that is the same, it means the short term and are subject to repurchase. For example, the repo rate is the repurchase agreement, you might have heard that. So let's move to another news article. So another news article is about India-China relationship. So recently the talks have been started बिटवीन द इंडिया चाइना कॉप्स कमांडर्स. सो द पॉइंट हेयर टू बी नोटेड इज द प्लेस दैट इज चुसुल. सो यू हैव टू मार्क दिस प्लेस बिकॉज दैट विल बी इम्पॉर्टेंट फ्रॉम योर PIN places in news. So you should try to locate this, and tomorrow I'll show you the map of Chushul. So let's move to the next article. So the next article comes from the Indian Express, wherein the author has depicted many fundamental flaws about the GST. So the first thing the author says is the GST is unable to be implemented properly, and the idea of one nation one tax remains a theory. So the second point which author has depicted here is the high rate of GST has made the industry uncompetitive, and the export have drastically reduced. The third point which the author here depicts is the idea of a single slab tax structure remains an idea only, and along with the bureaucratic tinkering, the tax slabs has frequently been changed by the government. The fourth thing which the author here depicts is there is a lack of anti-profiteering agency which can oversee that whether the GST is properly implemented or not. And the fifth thing which the author is saying that the many states are means having losses regarding to GST, and there is no proper means proper agency which can oversee that whether the merchants and the person who are getting indebted due to the GST are properly been provided the proper compensation or not. Similarly, the author has depicted many other fundamental flaws regarding to the GST of India, and the solution which author is giving here is about there should be the drastically change in the policy decision making, and we should have a bold decision making, and we should converge all the tax slabs, and we should include the diesel, petrol as well as in the GST design. So let's talk about the compensation cess. So the compensation cess is the cess which is a guaranteed compensation by the central government if the GST revenue falls below the 14% of in an annual growth rate. Okay, so the base year for it is 2015-16. So this cess will be levied on select goods and entities till 1st July 2022, and all the taxpayers except those specified goods who have opted the GST composition scheme are liable to connect and remit the GST compensation cess. And the point to be noted is all the money that belongs to the government of India comes from the Consolidated Fund of India, and then this money is coveted to the GST Council or GST Compensation Fund, because any entity which is means all the taxes are collected to the CSI, and the CSI ultimately passes away the taxes to further. The next news appears is about the Rafael. So the fourth, it's a good news for us that the fourth means the first batch of four Rafael fighter jets is coming to India by July, and it's more important because there are rising tensions with China recently. So that's all for this article. Let's move to the next article. So recently DGCI has given approval for the first human clinical trials Covaxin in the country. So it is basically a Hyderabad based vaccine makers, that is Bharat Biotech, that has been given the permission by Indian Council of Medical Research and National Institute of Virology for phase 1 and phase 2 human clinical trials. So let's study something about the DGCI, because UPSC continuously not asked these questions that who has developed this vaccine, but the point to be noted is DGCI.
So DGCI is a gamut of Central Drug Standard Organization, which in short form we call it as a CDSO, which is responsible for the approval of licenses in specified categories of drugs and blood products as well. So DGCI, the basic function of DGCI is to lay standard and the quality of manufacturing, selling and import and distribution of drugs across the India. So it is an appellate authority as well in the dispute redressal mechanism. For example, the consumer forum, in various consumer things. The third thing to be noted here is it prepares the national reference standard for basically the quality of drugs, and it uniformly brings all the enforcement of the all the Drugs and Cosmetics Act. So the drug analysts are being deputed at the state drug laboratories to oversee the proper implementation of Drugs and Cosmetic Acts. So let's move to the next article. So next article is about India should be cautious about what happened in the Galwan Valley. And in this regard, the MEA has released a statement: if there will be not conducive means environment, the India will have to react over it, and we will give a befitting reply to China. So you know as well that India is a soft power, means we have never attacked any country, and whosoever have attacked us, we have given them a befitting reply, either it be Pakistan, either it be China. So let's move to the next article. So the next article is about the Naga insurgency and the Naga peace accord. So here in the article, the author has depicted a constitutionally good thing, that is article 371b. So the article 371b of Constitution of India 1949 says that there are special provision with respect to state of Assam, notwithstanding with the constitution, the president may by order with respect to the state of Assam provide the constitution and function of the committees of the legislative assembly of the state constituting the member of assembly elected by the tribal area specified part 1 table appended to the paragraph 20 of the 6th schedule, and such number of assemblies may specify the order, modification and made to be the rule and procedure of assembly of constitution. So this article becomes a part of the prelims, so I think you must have noted down the important points from it. So the next point here is about the annexation plan by Israel. So Israel basically has annexed few parts of the West Bank and recently as well as some parts of the Jordan Valley. So this thing has been become a international concern at international level, and the United Nations High Commissioner for Human Rights has said that the annexation, whether it is 30% or 100%, it is a major concern worldwide, and Israel should back away his decision and take away the annexation of the West Bank. So we will discuss the Israel-Palestine issue in a separate video, but the point to be noted is that there is continuous rise in the tensions between the Israel, and you must note these map points, that is Syrian Arab, Hafia, Nazimat, Jerusalem, Mediterranean Sea, Egypt, Jordan, Beersheba, Dead Sea, etc., etc. So here also the author have depicted the similar concerns that the violation of human rights across the Israel has led to in the Palestine has led the Palestinians or the Jews to move away from the country. So let's move towards the next article. So herein there is a concern regarding the continuous hacking of the COVID data. So in this regard, the author has said that there should be open data barometer to measure what is happening to individuals' data. Along with that, open data charter has been asked by author that should be used by the government. So the next article says that will the grains free stay will be continued by the center is not clear. So recently the government of India launched the Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Ann Yojana. Under this scheme, the government announced 3 month period and there will be free food delivery to all the people, and around 80 crore ration card holders, each household were provided 5 kg of food grains. So in this regard, the author has said that will the center continue it or not. The important point from your exam point of view is Pradhan Mantri Garib Kalyan Yojana, and we will discuss it in the prelims crash course, so stay tuned. And the second is about the hunger crisis, and let's discuss this article, which is about the Chenab Valley terror free. So the important point here is the Chenab Valley. You should locate it in the map along with the Kulchuhar area of Anantnag. You should note these points and map it in the map practice. So India, Bhutan recently signed a hydro project which is of 600 megawatt Kondlunchu project. You should mark it where is Kondlunchu project and which rivers it joins. And it is a part developed in the eastern region of Tarishyakse. So the project, the concession agreement was signed earlier when the Narendra Modi went to the Bhutan. So in this regard, the author has said that progress on preparing the site ground halt in December. India knew a power tariff guideline for the cross border tariff transportation. So next article appears about the street vendors scheme. So the Union Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs recently launched a portal that is Pradhan Mantri Street Vendors Atmanirbhar Nidhi PM Sannidhi scheme, under which scheme the economic package of various sectors affected by the COVID-19 pandemic lockdown were being provided a loan to the street vendors as well as other operational peoples to start their startup again. Their shops or street vendors means their food shops and all again. So for that one may register in itself in PMS Samvidhi MHO.gov.in, which is an integrated end-to-end interface enabling user to take benefit of the scheme. So the next article is about UN resolution. So herein the UN resolution has been, the name of UN resolution has been replaced from the shared vision of a common future to the common future of present and coming generation. So you should note this point and you should refrain from writing this phrase in your GS optional as well as GS answer writings. So hope you like the video. It's our first video. We are trying to improvise the content and we are trying to improvise ourselves as well. So stay tuned. We will definitely try to deliver the best content available in all the market. Thank you. Have a nice day. Regards team, aap IAS.